Hey guys, it's Christopher from, my boy here, Yule. He's going to be my patient today. I know you're probably wondering, what is going on? We are here to do a small procedure, for our upcoming, nurses out there. So we're going to start with the vital signs procedure. So come with us. On this video, so we're going to, like I said earlier, we're going to be doing the vital signs. So basically, what's vital signs? So vital signs are the normal nursing procedure that is very, very essential. Now, the aim of this vital signs procedure that we're doing is for you to get the baseline data of your patient. Now, what do I mean by baseline data? Baseline data has to do with your patient's pulse, your patient's blood pressure, your patient's temperature. And these things give you an idea of what the body is like, the patient's body is like, before you carry out any extra procedures. That's what baseline means. So, all right. So, first of all, before our guy is pretending to be asleep, Gabba, wake up. So, before you perform any procedure, okay, first of all, note that this vital signs, forget this thing you're seeing, it is a trip procedure, all right? It is a trip procedure. Our nursing dudes can understand what I'm saying. So it's a trip procedure. What has to be there? Your sphygmomanometer for your blood pressure, your stopwatch, or you have to have a timepiece to check the pulse. What else? A thermometer. You have a thermometer for the temperature, and then you have the stethoscope to hear the crack of sound. Probably wondering, what's the crack of sound? I'm going to tell you. All right, so before you perform any procedure, you have to first of all greet the patient and introduce yourself, right? So first of all, you go like this. Good morning, Mr. Yole. My name is Nurse Christopher, and I want to check your vitals, sir. I don't know if that's okay with you. What you're doing here is that you're getting consent from your patient. And you must not proceed until he has given your consent. So, sir, may I proceed?
May I proceed?
Thank you, sir. So you thank the patient, and the next thing that you should do is to move your equipment to the patient's bedside. So they are here, all right? Then once you're done, you screen the patient. You can see that. So you screen the patient, and then you perform hand hygiene, which I've already done, all right? So let's go. Now, another thing that you have to bear in mind is that when you see a patient, before you perform any procedure on the patient, you have to make sure, especially vital signs, you have to check the patient. Is he on an IV line? You have to check. Well, our brother Yule here isn't on one. So let's just say that he's sleeping. Okay? Okay. You do not wake a patient up when he's sleeping unless it is very important. You understand? That maybe you're trying to meet up with... he has a surgery to go for by some sort of time or something like that, but you get the idea. So now we have to ask our patient now, because he's very mobile. You can see how he's moving. He has refused to stay one place. So you ask the patient if he can sit, right? And if the patient says yes, he can actually sit, and then you now perform the procedure. Or if he cannot, you now say, okay, you take the procedure on. You take the procedure, and he might need assistance. So in his case, I think he needs assistance. So let's help him.
I don't need assistance.
I get talking. So now he's in a comfortable position. So are you comfortable, sir?
Yeah, very, very all right. Comfortable.
So okay. So next thing that you do now is that, right? So then you bring out your. First of all, you're going to be taking the blood pressure, right? Now you go to your patient's left side. Why are you doing this? Because the heart is on which side? The left side of the body, all right? So the anatomy and physiology, people should read it. These are to my juniors. So please, my junior colleagues, I'm gonna read though. So this is for the sphig now. So now you're seeing here, this is, the inflator, this is the cuff, right? Now, this is the gauge. As you can see, it's number 2, 300. And the SI unit for blood pressure is mmHg, which means millimeter mercury. All right, the normal range is for systolic pressure, blood pressure. Now, okay, you're probably wondering what is systolic blood pressure. The normal systolic blood pressure is 100 to 120 millimeter mercury, and the normal diastolic blood pressure is 60 to 80 millimeter mercury. Make sure to remember that, all right? Okay, so now you've obtained consent, you've done everything, you've placed patient in a comfortable position. Now, the next thing you do is that you make sure that your stethoscope is with you. This is what you're going to be using to detect the crack of sound. Now, you clean the earpiece. Now, this is the earpiece, all right? Make sure that it's clean, make sure it's neat, right? Because you're going to be inserting this in your own ears, unless you have your own personal stethoscope. And even if you do, you make sure that you clean it, all right? It's good to stay clean. All right, so, now, first of all, what you have to do is that you make sure that your patient's left arm is at the level of his heart, right? Because arms, when the arm is lower than the level of the heart, the blood pressure tends to be higher than normal, right? Now, next thing you do is that you use your arm and you try to detect the brachial pulse, right? Now, once you've done that, you tie the cuff around it, all right? Now, as you've tied the cuff, you make sure that the tubes are overlying the brachial pulse, which is at the cubital fossa. This is the cubital fossa. Don't worry, you guys, but for you to be doing this, I'm sure you have some knowledge of anatomy and physiology, and you know that this cubital fossa is actually very important in checking the blood pressure. All right, once you've done this, your next thing you do is to put your gauge. Now, we are not using this right now in this video, but note that the mercurial sphygmomanometer is the most accurate sphygmomanometer. All right, bear that in mind, the mercurial one. All right, next thing that you do is that you get his radial. Okay, before that, you make sure that your valves are closed, right? All right, valves are closed, and then you deflate. Now, next thing you want to do is that you want to get the radial pulse, all right? Now, once you have the radial pulse, you inflate. You inflate to a point where you can no longer feel it, and then exceed by 30 millimeter mercury. All right, we'll close the valve and then move on. And once you're doing this, make sure not to cause your patient any discomfort. All right, so I hope you're okay. All right, now you exceed. I can't feel it any longer, so you exceed 30, which is about 180. It's at 180 now. All right, now I'm going to pump again to 180 and deflate. Now I'm going to place my stethoscope. All right, I'm going to place. It's normally locked, and you have to make sure that it's open for you to detect the crack of sound. All right, right now it's open, but it normally comes locked. Here, this is where you lock, and this is where you open. Yeah, you can turn it, all right? So it's open right now, and then you place it at the median side of the cubital fossa, where the brachial artery is located, all right? And then making sure that you can see the gauge, you inflate. To 180, all right? And then you slowly deflate, slowly. You can inflate again. Now, when you're doing this, you have to make sure that the first place you start hearing the crack of sound. The crack of sound are thuds. They come in front of thuds. You know how the heart sound comes in a laptop. But not like that, just thuds, right? It starts, when it starts, it's called the systolic, All right, the systolic blood pressure, when it ends, is it diastolic. Remember, you're slowly deflating. Right. You thank your patient. Thank you, sir. You take away all the instruments, all the equipment. Hope you're not in pain, sir. Alright.
That's all.
Okay. Now, you tell the patient his blood pressure, right? Now, sir, your blood pressure was 120 over 80. It's just perfectly normal, alright? And the next thing that you have to do is that, okay, you will now take the pulse, alright? Okay, now we're going to check them. We're going to be taking his pulse. Now, the pulse is the wave felt on the blood vessels as blood flows straight when it's being pumped by your heart. Okay, and then there are different sides for taking pulse pressure. All right, now there's the temporal, there's the carotid, there's the brachial, there's the radial, there's the femoral, there's the popliteal, and other things, you know. Okay, and another thing is that the pulse is measured in beats per minute. All right. Mean that you're going to check how many beats you get in a minute, right? Now we're going to be using a very common site. The most common site is the radial pulse. That's the radial artery, all right? So now the radial artery is the one that is close to the radial bone. Now the radial bone is on the lateral side of your arm, which is that's the one closest to the thumb. This bone right here, and this is your radius, and this is your ulna. All right, so you're going to be feeling that pulse along this region. All right, so let's go. Now you're going to press firmly against the radial bone, you know, to make sure that you're getting that pulse. All right, which I am feeling right now. Now once you start feeling the pulse, you're going to now calculate how many beats you're getting in a minute. All right, which we have done. All right. Now, once you've gotten that, you thank the patient once again, and then you now tell him what his pulse rate was. So your pulse rate was 70 beats per minute, sir, and you're totally fine. It's normal, all right? Thank you very much, sir, for your cooperation. All right. And then when you've done that, you record both your pulse and for your blood pressure, and it's the time too, right? Once you're done with that, you pack all your equipment, you thank the patient, you help the patient assume a comfortable position. Yes. Make sure that it's comfortable. Make sure that you screen the patient, and then remove away your equipment, and then perform hand hygiene. So that's everything for now on anything and everything. And thank you for staying with us. Do well to subscribe and tell all your friends about it. All right, thank you.